All the long frozen winter we worked our trap lines in the ice, snow, and blizzard, out watching for signs of marten and beaver, fox black and silver, fox black and silver and red. Whilst hidden they thought from Daniel's keen sight, Snack's pirates spied on us from dawn to daylight. In the spring they'll steal from us our prizes, they think, our muskrat, our raccoon, our wolf, and our mink. But we've outfoxed poor Snag, and we've paid him his due. Spring is here, we're bound homewards in our own canoe, with a fortune in fine pelts worth thousands of pounds, our muskrat, our beaver, and fox just abound.
You're exaggerating. I'm supposed to. This is a ballad.
Daniel.
Another trapper bound for home with his winter's take. He didn't fool the river pirates.
Just like you said it would.
Mingo!
Secure him!
Why waste good rope?
Why don't we just...
Do as you're told. You may have outdone that petty thief, Joe Snag. Nobody outfoxes Mr. Quaife.
Well, get down to the boat.
Maybe someone will happen along to untie you. Maybe not.
Boone, Daniel Boone.
leg bad?
Bad enough so that it may provide a new ending for my ballad.
I'll wait around and see how it comes out.
Good.
Good.
Good? How good?
It's not too bad. You think you'd be able to travel with a crutch?
Well, it's a long walk back to Boonesboro.
Boonesboro? And leave our winter's catch of furs with Mr. Quaife? What kind of ballad are you making? I went through clean as a whistle. I'll put a poultice on him. He's good as you. Dark for long. Nothing eats quite as good as fresh caught trout.
It's lucky you had a fishing line.
Now, do you think Rebecca Boone would send her husband out without a sewing needle and a hank of good strong sewing thread?
The Lord bless Rebecca Boone.
And don't forget the bait.
The Lord bless fat grasshoppers.
No, you don't. You move pretty fast for a man with a hole in his leg. It's your gentleman.
You know, Daniel, for the first time, I'm beginning to believe that we're going to get our furs back.
Well, I wouldn't know what else to say to Rebecca otherwise.
Half my share of the furs for a canoe. Almost, I said. Not before I've had a chance to ram Mr. Quaife's mister down his silly throat.
We better keep out of sight of the river for now. Let's go this way.
For my clumsiness now?
No harm done. That hole in your leg isn't entirely cured. It might come in handy if the going gets tough. If I were Mr. Quaife, I just might post another sentry hereabouts. Somebody to follow.
Are you sure you want a three-legged jackass alone?
No, a jackass that can crawl. Thank you.
Pick us off like roosting pigeons if we try to come in from the water side. They get down that path.
We'd need an army behind us.
He just happens to be one hereabouts. Belongs to a fellow named Joe Snag.
Joe Snag? He's at least the pirate that Quaife is.
Yeah, more from what I hear. Meaner, tougher.
And more buckos in his gang.
Mingo, you've hit it. Joe Snag can take our gear and furs from Quaife.
What good would that do us?
That I haven't figured out yet.
Can't you fellas read?
Yeah, I can. Can you?
Oh, well, matter of fact, no. But there's a certain school teacher that left here under false pretenses if that there sign don't say, keep out.
It does.
Well?
It's gonna take more than a school teacher's sign to keep me from going where I'm headed.
Oh, well, now. How much more?
We're right. This will come in handy.
How much are you offering?
Well, now, me, I'm the original untainted non-pariah. Sired by a bolt of lightning out of a grizzly bear. Rattlesnake poison was mother's milk to me, and I just run up mountains to jump off the other side.
Well, I stomp mountains flat just to make prairies out of them. I'm a sidewinder, and I poison rattlesnakes. Grizzly bears turn pale and run away in herds at the sound of my footsteps.
Ooh. Well, then, you just wade right on in, Sidewinder.
Come on over here!
Come on!
Never been as good a man as me.
I can't claim to be better.
Huh? What you doing here anyway?
Looking for a fella named Joe Snag.
Joseph. Well, why didn't you say so in the first place? You saved us a lot of trouble. On the other hand, we'd have missed a whale of a battle. I'm Joe Snag, here.
Oh, I'm glad to meet you.
Hey, come here. I want you to meet some of these scroungy lot here. It's my men. They're kind of a scroungy-looking lot, but you get used to them after a while. Hey, you know, it wouldn't do some of you critters no harm to have a bath once in a while. Boy, you'd like to done me in. Hey! Oh, I found me a live one here.
Grub time?
Yeah, Captain sent me along to see if you need anything.
Sure, everything's fine.
Well, he says anything you need, you just sing out and he'll get it, or his name ain't Joe Snag.
Our compliments to the host. Thank him for us.
Oh, well, he said when you get done to come on over to the castle. It's right over this way.
Yeah, we'll find it. I forgot how clean feels.
That's one thing you pale faces can envy the red man. We don't grow whiskers only to hack them off.
How's the leg?
Almost as good as new. You know, Daniel, I think you've made a friend in that pirate.
It's just the first step in getting him to get our furs from Mr. Quaife.
I didn't see you stay on his good side. But I really don't see how we're going to get the furs away from Joe Snag.
I'm surprised we got in to see him in one piece.
Well, that's not what you led me to believe. Oh?
Bring me some corn.
Get your own!
Show manners. Now, we got guests are coming. Don't you know you ain't supposed to eat before they get here? Here, priest. Take it out and get it filled up. Be quick about it. Priest!
But I ain't sitting at the table now, Captain.
Where's the sidewinder?
We'll be right along, Captain.
Now put that food down like I told you.
Hey, sidewinder. Hey, come on over here. You sit right there. Hey, you right there. Give Matt a little room.
There you go. Here, move down. There we are. Very best is.
Much obliged. That's a handsome piece.
Well, that's the last of the line. Yeah, we melted down the rest of them to make rifle balls. Got them off of some English lord or something. He was on his way up to Canada. Thought he was going to be a district governor or something like that. Hey, here, have some victuals. This replenishment's coming. Hey, no. Here, you just go and take all that. There'll be more along in a minute.
It's quite a setup you've got here, Snag. We kind of expected to see you sleeping and eating out of doors.
Oh, no, I don't mind eating in here. But now, when it comes to sleeping, I need some room. Yes, sir, I say eat and sleep out. That's my motto.
Anybody mind?
Hey, now, you be careful that snake. Eh? Them bullwhips is treacherous weapons in the hand of a man don't know the ifs and ands and buts about it.
Yes. You better fall into it, mateys. Eat hearty, mates. There's much more where that came from, I assure you. Did you see what he did? He didn't even touch me. I bet you cannot do that again. Dare you try it?
I dare.
Good. But this time I'm going to make it a little more difficult, huh? Yes. I'm going to hold this between my teeth.
Don't be a fool. You'll cut off your nose, then where will you be?
Yes. I know what I'll do. I will keep my pistol aimed at you, and if you just as much as tweak my nose, I will pull the trigger and kill you dead. Is that fair, man?
Yeah, that's fair.
Even money won't dare to come near.
1 to 3, he doesn't. Takes priest's nose.
1 to 5, I'll cover you.
No, you're on.
Hey, come, you ready?
Ready.
No, sir, that sure enough looks like your kind of weapon. Here, now sit down. We're going to get some victuals in you. Here, pass that. That's it. Let me have that up here. Yes, sir, there's plenty more where that come from. Here, let's have some of that. Yes. There's some good old homemade bread for you. Right. Say, listen, what am I going to call you, gentlemen?
Sidewinder will be just fine. Now, why don't you just call me Cherokee?
Hey, now, you must be real bad men if you was afraid to tell even me your right name.
Would say they'd give something to have us back where we came from.
Well, now, Sidewinder, I'm going to be right proud to have you and my crew.
Well, either that or you could join mine.
Why, this man don't know no shame at all.
Well, I'll admit you got more men than I have, but I didn't come here empty-handed. Now, what would you say about 1,000 pounds worth of the finest furs to ever come out of the Cumberland?
What would I say? Well, I'd say, how do you know about that?
I saw him. Dan'l Boone himself picked him out.
Oh, now Dan'l Boone ain't been up this part of the country.
He's been trapping all winter.
Has he now, for a fact? Huh. You know, I sure would consider it an honor to rob a man like Dan'l Boone.
Oh, that's not such a feat.
Now, you just hold on a minute there, Cherokee. He ain't no pirate, that's for sure. But in his own way, in his line of work, well, he's, well, he's just the best they is. Hmm. Where's he got these here furs?
Well, he doesn't have them right now.
Oh, well, who does?
Do you, know a gentleman by the name of Quaif?
Quaif? Do I know Quaif? I'll tell you I know that horned toad. Oh, I sure wish I knew what hole he hides himself in.
I know.
You found Mr. Quaife's hiding place? I'm gonna tell you something. I've been up and down this river from one end plumb to the other and back, and I can't find it. Sidewinder, you is sneaky. Now, don't you go hiding your light under a bushel. Sneaky's the word, and sneaky's what it is. Now, are you sure that he's still got them furs of Mr. Boone's?
Well, he did yesterday.
Huh, that's good. Well, tomorrow morning, we'll just go right down there and get them.
Well, Cam, the spring supply boat pulls into Cumberland tomorrow. We wouldn't want to let that pass.
Supply boat? Bluebelly, Mr. Quaif is a blot on the trade of piracy. Well, I'd give up that supply boat just to rob Mr. Quaif for free. Well, almost for free, yeah. Might give me absolution for my sins.
If we started now, we could grab those furs and be back by first light.
Sidewinder. You know, when I knocked you off on that bridge, and then you pulled me right in on top of you, oh, I did admire you for that. Yes, sir, I liked you. But now, well, you giving me a chance to rob Mr. Quaif of 1,000 pounds in coin of the realm. Well, now, that's just nothing but pure friendship. Well, now, you know something for a fact. I just dote on you. Yes, I do. All right, you scallywags, drop them vittles and go look after the boats. Right now, do you hear me? Yeah. Oh, no. Now, you just sit right there and have your meal comfortable. Yeah, that's all right. It's all right. There ain't no hurry. Hey. Priest! Sidewinder, what do we do now?
Well, Cherokee and I'll scout him from the top and get my position set for the diversion.
What do you mean, Cherokee and you? What's wrong with me?
Well, he and I are used to working together. You know, Indians travel quiet.
Well,
I know you're the captain of this outfit, but since I told you about the...
All right, all right. Never let it be said that Joe Snag stand in the way of a man's moment of glory.
Well, I'll send Cherokee back just as soon as I get things set.
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
Thank you.
century better. This one's a little edgy for my taste.
Joe Snag's gonna be too edgy for mine if we don't get back and report pretty soon. We have to do the best we can. See if those furs are still there. So far, so good. We can just snake them out and get away ahead of Joe Snag's group. I almost hate to do it to Joe. Pirate or not.
All right, you men. Let's get those furs together. Jed Harris is coming by early to pick them up.
Let's get back to the guns.
Should have gone with him.
Well, Captain Sidewinder knows his trade.
That he does. Master at the art of piracy.
See, I wonder what his real name is.
Your mother sure didn't name you Bluebelly. Now, a man's name is his own business.
We're all set here. You better get back to Snag. I just hope Jed Harris isn't too early. Gets up behind that big pine on the hill. I'll start a diversion. That'll give you time to get back to Snag to make sure he's ready to move.
Captain, do you know a man by the name of Jed Harris?
Yeah, he's a fence that I favor with my trade from time to time.
Well, Quaif is selling him the furs.
Jed Harris is a-doing business with that no-good fluke. Well, by the time I get through with him, he'll think that the devil's pitchfork is a mother's gentle hand.
Captain, Sidewinder is waiting for reinforcements.
Oh, yeah. Lieutenant, mount the battle flag. Go ahead, sir. Yes, sir. Sir.
Your
There we go. Should have heard from him by now.
Don't you worry about Sidewinder.
I tell you, he's in some kind of trouble.
Now you sing out like I told you. Sing out.
Mr. Quaife! The whole army's attacking us!
Man, drag him out! Let's go there.
Obey your orders, men.
Shoot anything that moves. Light.
Soon be over. Snag's boys seem to be winning. It's time we moved.
Huh? Came back to get yourself whipped proper, huh?
A little trouble there, fellas? Hey, here, give you a hand. Hey, that was good thinking, Sidewinder. Getting that swag out of here before them thieves had a chance to steal it back.
Oh, the rest of them will be right along.
Yeah, that won't be very long either from the sound of things up there. All right, now let's give it a heave over here. Get on there.
His own whip.
real smart. As soon as they see the Swaggers gone, the fight went right out of them.
Yeah, well, that was Sidewinder's idea, not mine.
Oh, and you deserve a celebration, friend.
Yeah. We all do. Yeah, what are we waiting for?
Well, we don't want to leave the Swag unguarded, do we?
You don't think Quaife would dare to show his face after the licking we gave him?
The doctor won't let him.
He ain't got a whole man left to him.
Sidewinder's right again. Lieutenant, you stay here and keep an eye on things.
Well, me? Well, Captain, I ain't slept pretty near two nights.
Well, we can take turns, spell one another. I'll take the first watch. Cherokee can relieve me.
No. Now, you two done enough already. More than your share. You keep an eye on that warehouse. You two follow me. Yes, sir, I'm going to tell you. Oh, come on. Here, you two more fast than you thought, huh? Well, just come along with me now. A little hot grub and a couple of tots of rum, you'll feel like a couple of yearling coats just to kicking up your heels. That's right. Watch the low bridge there. Hold on.
Oh, Mrs. Lee, we get that hard sick. This is Rachel's butt. You got to eat it. Come on, Mr. Lee.
Well, I can see that. There sure ain't nothing wrong with your head.
Any orders, Captain?
All at ease, priest. Here. Hey, try again.
I never saw anything like it in my life. He had a saddle on it, 7 feet long and about a foot and a half.
Hey, Sidewinder.
I want you to taste some of the best squeezing that you ever throwed a lip over. Here, you go on.
Whoa! There won't nobody around here complaining about the vegetables not being washed. Why, that's the finest grape squeezings that we've had in the last year or two. I won't tell you that. Look at there, just as clean as a whistle, that's what they are. Hey, how about that there, Sidewinder? Now I'm going to tell you, if you ain't a pleasurable fellow to have around. Yes, sir, it was too warm today anyway. Hey, you don't want to drink all of that now, do you? Hey, now.
You two want a shut eye? I got just the place for you to catch yourselves 40 winks. Hey, go on right there. Go on.
What's the matter? Can't you sleep, Nina?
Would you two be quiet? I'm trying to get some sleep.
Yeah. Hey, sorry about that, Cherokee. Hey. Hey, man.
Celebration, we thought maybe you'd like a turn.
Boy, my throat's as dry as beach sand at low tide. Oh, hey, thanks. I sure do appreciate that. Yahoo!
Hey,
Hold it right there, Snag.
Tell you something.
There's something. Joe Snag has missed us or the furs, and he's looking for us.
He's not alone.
Celebrating.
We'll take them before they know what's happening.
No, we're going to have a little fun together before I put a pistol ball through your head.
This is one time we're going to look out for ourselves. Look out after ourselves.
Now, just as soon as my boys finish off your scurvy crew, you're going to come back with us and provide some rare entertainment.
It's my pleasure.
While we're waiting, why don't we practice? Dance for me, Snag. Dance.
Yeah, stay blue, don't you?
Hey, me here!
No, no, now don't you worry about a thing. Be all right. Yes, sir. I want to watch. Watch you hang. Slowly. Oh, now don't you fret, none. My men will take care of themselves. Don't you worry about that. I just want to make sure that you didn't do no harm to my friends. Mm-hmm. Well, my friends here.
Oh, that's rich.
What you talking about?
These are the ones I stole the furs from in the first place. They used you as a cat's paw. Yes. Bet you the life of the best man in my crew they got him away from you by now.
Well, I thought Mr. Quaife was the one come down here and broke in that warehouse. I just come back here to save you fellas' lives. What? Ah, I missed him. And big as he was, too. I thought you two was my friends.
Well, believe me, Joe, we are.
Smell me some fresh meat cooking.
Feel well enough to eat?
Well, I ain't dead, am I?
Sorry we had to bring you here, but we couldn't risk having you and your men trail us.
Oh, yeah, well, that's all right. What now?
Well, we'll drop you off to Cumberland. Get yourself a boat and make your way back home.
Is that before they hang me or after?
Oh, I don't know. It's still a long way to Cumberland.
Yeah. A young'un. Shot trying to escape the hangman's noose, huh?
Oh, here.
Well, you'll need these getting home.
Well, what you gonna tell him?
Well, is it my fault if you overpowered me in the middle of the night?
Oh, hey, listen, I got a question.
So have I.
Well, what's yours?
Well, you really weren't worried, were you?
Huh?
I mean, you really were asleep.
Well, sure. Sidewinder, I done picked you out as a true and trusted friend.
My goodness gracious, I can't trust a friend. Well, land sakes, if I couldn't pick a man to trust no better than that. Well, just a question of time till I was going to get hanged anyway. Don't make much difference when. Now about my question. What they call you at home?
Daniel Boone.
Oh, you don't tell me. Whee! Now, what do you think of that? Now, that just goes to prove, you see, that I know how to pick a man I can trust, don't it? Well, Sidewinder, that is, Mr. Boone. Boy, that sure don't sound right to me. No, you're always going to be Sidewinder to me. I sure do hope we meet up again.
So do I. If not out here, if you ever come to Boonesboro, come see us.
No, I don't reckon I'll probably stray that far from home. Ain't no need to disturb him now.
Did too.
Did what?
Overpowered you? One way or another, he overpowered us both.
Pleasant dreams.
Pleasant dreams.